Wake that ass up.
Get up and get turned up with DeDe in the morning.
We get wild up here.
Man, did you guys hear that R. Kelly is not even mad at those women on that documentary?
Really?
Yep, they said he's not mad at them. He's not mad at his record label for pulling his music.
Mm.
They said R. Kelly is not even mad at the artists who have dropped his songs, Celine Dion and Lady Gaga.
Okay.
He's mad at other people.
Who he mad?
I swear to God, when I tell y'all who he's mad at, you're going to go, this man is dumb for real, y'all. Here we go.
It's getting hot in here.
Hot topic.
Yeah. The most unattractive thing, by the way, a dumbass man. Oh, it's unattractive. It's unattractive.
Not really.
Oh, Jay likes that.
No, it just depends.
I ain't gonna lie, I'm attracted to a dumbass shit.
You can't be dumb man around me.
I want you dumb.
Super dumb.
Oh, this one's dumb. When I tell you what, you gonna say, this fool is dumb.
But sometimes overly smart can be like, okay, we get it.
Teach me something, hell.
No, I don't teach
you. Police found, listen at this though, you guys. Really, we gotta talk about this. Cedar Hill police, they actually found that woman accused of robbing the 80-year-old. Remember last week we were talking about this?
Yes, they snatched a purse and a woman got drugged and she fractured her face and everything like that.
The 80-year-old did.
Yeah, the 80-year-old did. Turns out this chick, they've done this like 12 other times. So they catch people when they're coming out of the gyms.
Mm-hmm.
There was like 10 different situations in Cedar Hill. There was one in Allen, one in Arlington. What was the girl's name?
Melanie King, girl. I got her name already.
Melanie King.
You robbing people after cardio? What?
No, for real.
I'm going to tell y'all something. Melanie looked like she don't play. I'll be honest. If Melanie came for my purse, I'd hand it to her.
Yeah,
I'd just
be
like, you know, you want my purse? You can have the car too, Melanie.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't really want to mess with you.
And if you want, my mom's going to be out here in a few minutes. You want to rob her too?
You get her purse.
She look evil for real.
Don't she?
Melanie's the one like you sitting in church and they'd be like, turn to your neighbor and say,
no.
And you'd be like, no. I'm going to turn this other side.
Yeah. You try not to make eye contact with her in church. I'm not going to say hi to you. I'm going to talk to the one in front of me on this side. And
Melanie and Robbie doing the prayer dance.
But they got her.
In my pockets?
They got her. You guys see day 25 of the government shutdown. And Jade asked this question. Was it yesterday or the other?
Yesterday.
About the White House? And I said, I think they are. And they certainly are, everybody. The White House staff was affected on this shutdown as well. Because they ain't showing up for work either. And so we actually know this because the Clemson Tigers, they actually won last week.
The national championship, they beat Alabama.
And they
great game.
They went to the White House and Donald Trump served them McDonald's.
You got to be kidding me.
And Wendy's and some Filet-O-Fish and some cold fries, I swear to God.
We have pizzas, we have 300 hamburgers, many, many French fries, all of our favorite foods. I want to see what's here while we leave because I don't think it's going to be much. The reason we did this is because of the shutdown. We want to make sure that everything is right. So we sent out, we got this, and I will say the Republicans are really, really sticking together. It's great to see because we need border security. We have to have it. Should have happened 30 years ago, 20 years ago, 10 years ago, and it's going to happen now. Going to happen now. Thank you very much, everybody.
Thanks, guys.
Enjoy your food.
Don't just hold right here.
Good stuff. Grab one.
Thanks, guys.
Grab one, fellas. Grab one.
It's like, bro, I don't care about your agenda. You got me a quarter pounder with cheese. I had that yesterday.
Yes. I see your phone. Doing? You have Uber Eats.
Yes.
I see it. We're going to order different stuff.
I'll be honest with you. I got to thank him for that, though. Because he allowed me to actually
stunt.
Yeah, thanks, Jade. That's what I call it on Instagram, where I put up the pictures.
I unfollowed you this morning.
Yeah,
I did. So I blocked you, actually.
I put up the pictures when I went to the White House on the numerous times. And
because you didn't go once or twice.
Oh, no.
Or three times.
Six times. Never. No, yeah, no, more than that. It was seven.
Wow.
But anyway.
No, let me tell you what's funny about DeDe.
So
DeDe this morning goes into this whole thing of, I'm gonna put a picture up of the same table when I was there when Obama was in the White House.
Uh-huh.
And the food was so exquisite. There's selfies of you. It doesn't even have anything to do with the
exactly.
food.
That's the point.
Yeah. It's like,
I just wanted to stunt again.
DeDe has the Netflix White House code.
I was there so much. I had a room.
She had a room.
I was like, I can stay in the Lincoln bedroom, right? Will you take my luggage, somebody?
That's messed up.
But I haven't been invited this time. Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, and then finally, Iyanya Van Zandt. According to some reports, listen to this. R. Kelly, by the way, they said R. Kelly is mad at, he's not mad at anybody. None of the ladies are, he's mad at Lifetime executives and he's trying to get dirt on them, they said.
Yeah.
He's meeting with his lawyers every day to try to get dirt on those executives.
They had nothing to do.
The receptionist is upset.
Yeah, she's upset because dirt's coming up about what she's doing on the job.
Yeah.
The copy machine operator.
Yes. This is what he's doing for real, though. He's not mad at anybody else but them. But anyway, he reached out to Iyanya Van Zandt and said he wanted to be on her show and she said, no.
Oh, no.
How you going to deny Iyanya?
She said you can't fix his life. But
what?
But she said you can't fix it. She said he's not emotionally ready and stable.
I agree with
her. Or emotionally mature is what she said. But guess who wants to be on her show as well?
Who?
DMX wants to be back on her show.
Wasn't he already on there?
He was, and they got into it. Remember, they had a confrontation with his son in the. Listen to this, y'all. Remember this?
Always, but most of the time, very hostile, and it was always.
Towards you?
No. But just in the house.
Just one example. Just one, since I've done it so much. Since this is such a major
what
part.
What about today?
Man. I'm talking about. No, listen, man. I'm not going for this.
I was talking to Xavier.
Damn, y'all, yo, for real,
I was talking to Xavier. I'm not intimidated
by
you.
You don't gotta be intimidated, man. Stop running your mouth.
What about today?
I'm not even gonna have this debate, man.
And y'all what about talk, today?
You do that.
And when you really.
We'll talk. Will she stop running her mouth? Damn it. That's what we'll.
So she said he can come back on.
No, see, that doesn't make sense to me. You can let DMX come back up. First of all, I hate when, like, you give somebody an example, say, this is what you've been doing. They'd be like, well, if I do it so much, then tell me how give me an example.
Yeah, give me an example, damn it.
I don't want to give you an example. And if I give you
so
an example.
So what you bring it up for then?
Well, if I give you an example.
Man, stop running your mouth.
Shouts out to Iyanya Van Zandt, because she's bold to work with DMX, and you'll see him again.
Wake that ass up.
Get up and get turned up with DeDe in the morning.
We get wild with it.